One thing that's becoming painfully obvious around here, as I've been getting addicted to ordering cheap stuff from China and other online sources, is that I'm running out of places to put stuff. And even when I've got a place for it, it's hard to stay organized. So one of the things I have been doing for quite a while is I've been using these little multi-compartment boxes. This particular one is actually, they come in sets of three from Home Depot, and they are about $3 a piece. So that works out pretty well. It's relatively affordable. Some of the other things that I've been using, these boxes here, I got them from Michael's Craft Store. They're for beads or whatever they sell them for. But they work pretty good for stashing resistors in. Most of these came out of one of those resistor assortment packs that you can get from eBay or Banggood or Ali or any of the usual suspects. 30 or 40 values, 20 of each one kind of thing. So that works not too bad. And label them and pile them up behind me. Let me just spin around here. So there's those and some more of these boxes over here. So that's handy, and it's literally right behind where I'm sitting when I'm at my desk. Over beside it, I've got some of these drawer things. There's one there that's also really handy for me to just grab stuff from my workbench. And that's all since I've gotten into Arduino and whatnot and ordering stuff. Previously, I've got some other drawer sorters with model railroad stuff in them. More of these multi-compartment bins. Some older, smaller types. And these things actually, which work out not too bad, they call them plastic shoe boxes, and they're on sale at Home Depot for a couple of bucks quite often. And then just some various older boxes and whatnot that I've got stuff in. And another different type of a drawer thing. These drawers in this one and the other blue one, they're just one compartment per drawer. We've got an older one, where is it? Sitting down there, that's got, I think those drawers can do, up to three compartments in them, which is really handy, but I haven't had that one forever. I haven't seen one like that recently at the places that I buy stuff. And another drawer thing full of model railroading supplies. And another one over there full of model railroading supplies. And underneath these guys, more of the plastic shoe boxes with modeling supplies and heat shrink. And it just goes on and on and on. But all of those are full now. And I've still got these two things from my last mailbag that I haven't put away yet. So I need both some more containers and places to put them, because as you saw, my shelves are pretty much full too all around here. So went to Home Depot and got some more of these guys. Again, they're 3 for $10, so that's pretty good. Went to Princess Auto and got another one of those, which was also on sale. That's the other thing, I always buy this stuff when it's on sale. I don't buy it at regular price, so I wait until I see a good price and then I grab it. It's the only really way you can afford to have a hobby these days is to be a bit patient and buy stuff when its price comes to you rather than you just biting the bullet and going for it. That new drawer unit is identical to this one, which I probably bought a year ago when it went on sale. That's something I've noticed is a lot of these stores put the stuff, the same thing on sale the same time of year. So if you happen to notice that something you wanted just went back to regular price, just sort of make note of it and it'll come around again. But anyway, I'm thinking that I'm going to try and find a way to put the new one and this one on this shelving unit back to back, which is going to make it inaccessible. But something, a dumpster dive that I grabbed recently has, I think, solved that problem for me. I hope. And that dumpster dive item is this, which is a Lazy Susan bearing. Basically, it's two plates that you can screw stuff to, a top plate and a bottom plate. And, you see down there, ball bearing separating them. You can spin them around like that. Kitchens will have spice racks like that. This particular one was part of some kind of a cardboard... Ooh, focus you. Some kind of a cardboard display rack thing. Just use these plastic pegs on one side to hold it to the thing and double-sided tape to hold it to the other one, so I was able to liberate it fairly quickly without having to bring all that crappy cardboard home. So now my plan is to find some couple of bits of wood to put on this thing, and I'll probably screw it down and see if I can get that to sit on that shelf with the two parts bins on top of it. So in amongst my pack ratage, I've got a bunch of offcuts of wood and failed experiments here, but I think these two things, which are actually drawers or doors off an old cupboard that I scrapped, I think those will do the job. Put that on there, screw it down, figure out how to screw the other one onto the other side, and then one of these will be the base that sits on top of the cupboard. The other one will be where the two drawer thingies sit. Time to get busy. Okay, that's that liberated. So this one, that flat piece should screw down just through those holes. Oh, I see. And it looks like these larger holes here line up with the other four screws, so for coming through from that side. So I'll have to drill holes in this thing. So let's be a little bit neat and tidy about this. I'm going to go right there and there. So since there's four screw holes, I'm just going to make some approximately marks there. Kind of line those up so that when they're all four on the line, that should be pretty damn close to centered. Now then. And there's where I'll drill. So if they find drill bits, how big a drill bit do they need for that? Okay, now, if I did that right-ish. Those should kind of line up over there. And poke some screws into there. Okay. That's that part. Now, the easiest way, since these two pieces are the same, the easiest way to line this up, just do it like that. Okay. So the holes are disappeared there, but when I rotate it slightly, they reappear. I think, just so I don't bugger it up. Well, no, I was going to drill those, but no bother. Okay, make that a little bit magnetic, just so I don't actually knock it off going down the hole. I just pulled a stupid. Got the two white sides facing each other. I wanted the one white side facing up. Okay. Undo, flip her over, redo. It's gonna be a mark, don't care, this is shop furniture. There. All the way up it's gonna be. There. Now then, the bin things. Okay, there's the new one. Tear into her. Thinking. Put me kind of back to back like that. And oh, is that the, yeah, these are just slightly rectangular, so do it that way. Now then, how do I stop it from flying on? Yeah, that's no good. I guess I could just put a couple screws into the bottom there. Where's the middle on this unit? All right, 15 and a quarter plus an eighth. 15 and a quarter, 7.5, and half end, about that much. What? Yeah. So. Cheap rocket surgery, remember? It's just a shop tool. Kind of like that. And, I'll just use more of the same screws, yeah? Why not? I'm not holding against gravity, I'm just holding against centrifugal force. Centripetal acceleration. Whatever you prefer. Okay, that's the easy one because it's empty. The hard one to screw down is going to be the full one. Partly because it's full, and partly because how am I going to get back there with my drill to screw it down? Going to have a think on this. Okay, I've done some more digging around in my parts bins, and I've also noticed on the back of these things, they've got keyhole slots for mounting them on walls. And when I slide them together, they line up perfectly. So I dug through my part selection, found some nuts and bolts. And I think I can just barely get my hands in there to make said nuts and bolts meet. So I think that's what I'm going to try and do here. is going to be a little bit blindfoldy, a little bit droppy. I think I can make it work. Well, that was easy. No, it wasn't. It seemed easy. That sucked. That really was annoying. Actually, I should have left the light in there for a second. Just show you what I ended up doing. So, back in there, there is one bolt, and there is t'other one back in there, and those are clamped in tight, so that's not going anywhere. Right, now let's put the doors back in and put it into the room and see if it actually sits in there, and we'll spin around without knocking everything else on the floor. Okay, and there it is in its spot. There's the side that's fully loaded, and there's... Oh. Okay, hang on a minute, I'm going to have to readjust my pile of stuff over there. Okay, I moved the airbrush off the top of the box of assorted length of wire. And slid the box itself over a little bit. So now we should be able to clear that corner. Yes, we can. And there's the empty side ready for filling. The other thing that gives me a little bit of space there, I can store a few things in that should clear that. Nice! Now I have room for more stuff. And once I get stuff put away, I'll be able to order even more stuff. Ha ha! Anyway, thanks for watching. Putting up with me again for another Friday. If you have any comments, throw them down in the comment section down the bottom there. And I will talk to you next week.